I hope you know what you're getting into. Because now it's time for me to school the university. Tell me, do you paint?
Alright, Steve, how was that?
Oh, that was such a good video, Crow. Oh, gave me chills.
Hey, guys, you mind if I join in?
Wait, who's that? I can't see a damn thing out of this mask.
Who the hell are you, and how'd you get in here?
Oh, the name's Krowcast Crowstar, and the door is open.
Hey, what do you mean the door's open? The door's obviously closed. Look, I don't know how you got in here, but you're gonna have to leave.
Listen here, you son of a bitch. I run this shit. So, if you want any way out of this, you do as I say. Capiche? Or I'll fucking cut you.
Oh, yeah, sure. Whatever you say.
Well, I'm glad that's all settled.
So, should I just keep the mask on?
Just go ahead and keep that mask on. It looks great.
Yeah, I guess go ahead and just keep it on.
Swell. So don't mind me, I'll just be over here in the corner. Won't I, Steve?
Yeah, sure.
Alright, so let's just go ahead and roll into the review. Hey, what's going on, guys? Krosama here. So today we're taking a look at the high-grade Gafran from Gundam Age. Now this is the unknown enemy from Gundam Age, and basically the main grunt suit on the enemy side. Really, really cool looking suit. I love the design overall, and it's a really cheap kit. Even now, it's not really being scalped, or, you know, there's not a higher end market for it. So you can still get these relatively cheap, even though the reissue has been pretty low. And this video is sponsored by newtypehq.com. If you want to get some good Gunpla goodness, some tools, or any kind of accessories, you can go to their website and pick up some stuff for yourself. Now, for talking about the box, none's really going on too much with it. It did retail at 1200 yen, and like I mentioned, it doesn't go for that much more, but you probably will be looking a little bit at two times the price, so maybe somewhere in the mid-20s is going to be the aftermarket on eBay or other similar sites. Now let's look at the details. Honestly, this is a really beautiful looking mobile suit. And it's really funny because it doesn't really have that mobile suit look. It has a very organic kind of feel to it. Something like you would see from maybe, you know, Victory Gundam. But I love the dragon kind of motif. It is just really sick. Everything about it, it just screams like this is an enemy. There's no ally to be seen in this particular mobile suit. Now, there really isn't much surface level details, like especially like on the wings, there's not many like panel lines or anything that you can panel line on this thing. It's really just a lot of smooth surfaces. There are a little bit of etched in parts, and I would honestly like to know what this suit would look like with a bunch of panel lines on it and a more mechanical kind of design. Now for the articulation, it's actually really good because it does have a transformation which we'll see a little bit later, but the butterfly hinge on the shoulders is going to allow it to have a lot more movement, and then there's also going to be movement in the knees, and it just gives it a little bit of extra kind of like agility and just maneuverability. The one thing that's really going to be hindering this entire kit is going to be on the hips. Basically, there's going to be a ball joint there, so it's not doing any kind of crazy splits and not too many really good movements in terms of, like, you know, poses and action stuff. It's a little more basic, but you still can pull off some nice stuff even with the ball jointed hips. Now, for accessories, it really just has extra hands. That's basically all you're going to be getting. Not really too bad because I do love the Vegan fist. You know, it's really cool. I like the fact that you're going to get that. But the open hands are really fantastic. I do wish that there were like some more action poses, like for like this. You know, if you had a claw like that, that would be really cool. So that way it's doing this and it's kind of like shooting, you know, the little Gatling like that instead of just like this. I really wish it was a little bit different in the hands. At least like one hand had that option, much like the H1 normal high grade has. Then you do get some stickers, which is basically just going to be for the eyes. You get like two for the cheeks and then two for underneath the feet. Now for the transformation, it's really simple. All you're going to do is just move the flap of the little ears out. You're going to move the wings out, kind of rotate the shoulders forward, and then you're going to take the knees and you're going to just maneuver them into like a little chicken pose. You're going to take the little claws at the feet, you're going to rotate them out, and because kind of straight out the tail, that's pretty much it. You got your dragon mode. Now for weapons, this thing, although it doesn't come with like external weapons, like a sword or, you know, rifle and all that, it does have a lot of internal weapons and things that you can see right there. So you have like the little Vulcans right there in the palm of the hands. Those can actually shoot in the series. But not only that, it can actually generate a beam saber. So you can just take one of your yellow beam sabers that you have lying around and plug it right into there. Or you can basically just make your own with some plot plate or something of the sort. The chest is also like a spread beam. It just kind of like shoots a little bit wildly a little bit. It's not a very concentrated beam, but it's pretty cool that part's going to be in there. It is also clear green, just to note, but I would probably paint that more of a metallic, get something that's a little more reflective because it's really hard to see unless you have it in the light. And lastly, you have the tail, which is a little cannon, and that can go like over the shoulder, it can go underneath, it can go on the side of the body, wherever you really want that, you know, little cannon to be. I do like it over the shoulder because it just kind of looks really cool in that pose. But yeah, it's going to have these little sockets, and for the most part, these sockets are used to plug the hand in. You plug the little beam Vulcan in the palm, you plug that in, but it's really like difficult to get it to that kind of thing, and I don't remember seeing it in the show. I think it's more or less like if it's on the side, it can do that, but for the most part, you don't need to. You can just have it kind of like casually holding it on the side. So for my final thoughts, honestly, this is perfection. I absolutely love the Gafran. I think the high grade just, it just has so much like cool designs, so much like just energy radiating from it. I love it. And it's just a grunt suit. Like, how a lot of people feel about the Zaku is the same way I feel about the Gafran. It's a transformable grunt suit that actually kicked ass in the first arc. Sometimes you see things in, you know, other series, much like the Leos in Gundam Wing. The Leos are kind of trash. Like, I know they're okay-ish, especially like maybe like the flight types or space types, but Leos, for the most part, get trashed on. This is a very good, competent grunt suit in Gundam Age. It takes out a lot, and basically, when I say a lot, I mean all of the Genoaces, except for like maybe the custom, but even ace pilots have a hard time fighting off against a Gafran because they're just not, you know, they're not ready for it. It has too much armor, like penetration and coating to where it's negating any kind of weaponry from the Earth's Federation forces. It's just a very solid suit. So it's a cop it. It's an instant cop it in my book. And it's not really that expensive. You can still get it for very cheap. And this is one of those things that just looks so good with an army. I have three high grades, and I have two robot Damashis. I want more. I want more Gafrans. I just want an entire, you know, city diorama of just a bunch of Gafrans, like, you know, a bunch of crows coming in on the Age 1 normal. But the Age 1 normal is still a beautiful mobile suit. But that's all for me, guys. So thank you all for watching. Thank you to all the members who are part of this channel who just, like, support me every single day, especially the ones on Discord. You guys are champions. But that's all I got from me. I got one thing to leave with you. Please, please try and get into some Gundam Age. It's the 10-year anniversary. I don't know if the 15 or the 20-year anniversary is going to be any better, but I always feel like the 10-year anniversary is like one of the best things about a franchise. It's something that just like, it's the first true milestone. No one cares about the 5-year. No one cares about the other years underneath. It's that 10-year that kind of sets the standard for all the future years. So if y'all can, just talk about it. I don't need y'all to purchase anything if you don't want to, but go on Twitter, go on Instagram, go on Facebook, and just talk about it. Getting people talking about the franchise is what's going to get Bandai to recognize it, especially people in the Japanese community. So if you're Japanese or if you're somewhere within Asia and you have your clicks and you have your connections, please just talk about Age and convince them to talk about Age. It helps me, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna help the entire community who actually does like age. But that's it for me. Thank you all for watching, and hit that like, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, or I'm gonna find Runner B to your newest kit, and I'm gonna steal it.